Can we not do this right now? Can we just wait and talk about
it? No, Ben, I don't want to wait. I want to talk about it now.
But you're drunk.
I
want
to talk
drunk
about how every time
fight.
We go out, we barely make it through the door together, and then I don't see you again until you're ready to leave. Never mind if I want to stay.
If you wanted to stay, why didn't you say so before we left? Well, how can we have to wait till we're in the car and we're halfway home?
Like, that would have made any difference.
Yeah, you're right. It wouldn't have made a difference. Because if it wasn't this, it'd be some other silly fuck.
It's not silly. Don't do that. Don't dismiss me.
It is silly, Lisa. What are you mad about? Are you mad because we left before you wanted to? Or are you mad because I didn't spend the whole night glued to your fucking hip? Which is it?
Why do you have to be such an asshole?
I'm not being an asshole. I'm asking a straightforward question. You wanted to pick a fight, let's fight. What are we fighting about? Get me on the same page. Or do you even know? Because I don't think you do. I think like every other time you get a couple drinks in you, you just want to fight. God. But don't expect me to sit here and be your goddamn punching bag. What, are you done? You done? You get it all out of your system?
Fuck you.
Can you not slam my goddamn door?
Door.
Can you reach the sugar for me? Can you reach the sugar for me? Can you reach the sugar for me?
Can't you wait till I'm gone?
Have a good day.
You too.
So I figured out the perfect relationship. It involves me meeting two women who are already in a bisexual relationship. One of them is a tall, skinny blonde, as the other one is a small, plump Latina who's nurturing and stays at home and cooks a lot, and the other one's like a career woman, and they just use me as a sexual object.
Hey, guys. Sorry I'm late. All right, we ready?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Hi. Go ahead and sign in, fill out this form, and bring it back to me with a headshot and a resume.
Thanks.
They're ready for you.
Hey, babe. How'd it go?
I think it went okay.
Yeah?
Yeah. They only had me read once.
Is that good?
I don't know. I'm headed back now.
Oh, yeah? Where are you?
Just got on the freeway.
Jesus. I thought your audition was at 4.
Yep. And they were running way behind, and so I had to wait, and then I was in and out of that room in like 3 minutes.
I'm sorry, babe. So what time do you think you're gonna make it back then?
I don't know. Late. I just hit a lot of traffic.
Sucks.
Yeah.
Well, I guess I'll hit up the guys and go grab a beer or something since you're gonna be a while.
Okay, honey. Yeah, have fun.
Why don't you give me a call when you're getting close?
Okay, I will.
All right, sweetheart. Drive safe. I love you.
Love you, too.
Oh, no, it's from the old movies. No, I've always loved that name.
Ben and me from now on. Say it.
You are May.
May is going to fuck your brain.
Hi, you've reached Lisa Green. Leave me a message and I'll call you back when I can. Thanks.
Go. So we're in his car. I'm driving. We're on like a lot of acid. It's a fucking Thursday in East Texas. We're out by like Red River, out by BJ's.
Right, BJ.
Yeah, yeah, that old guy that came over and yelled real loud about the pot.
Yeah.
That's where I met them. No, that's where I met that Jessica bitch with the
lazy eye.
She looked like a giver.
She was like a 10, except for the fucking like lazy eye. To the
which
side.
You didn't even recognize face. Until like day 3 of hanging out with this bro.
This guy was just more like stroke face.
Well, just in the eyeballs, they're like calmless, because they're a little closer
yeah,
together.
Yeah, her shoulder was lower too. Like she lost that feeling.
Yeah, and apparently when I pass out, she's taking gravity long hits. Tend to hit my head on something, you know, straight. Like shaking like this.
You probably get a concussion.
I think so. Oh, that mom just Tinder messaged me again.
Maybe she's leading you on as a single mom.
He's still the fun age. He's like 4 to 7.
Still the fun age.
Yeah. So I can do Uncle
Sam. You know, put on SpongeBob and go fuck his mom.
The funny thing about Tinder is, if there's ever a picture of two women, you can guarantee that it's the ugly one.
But it wasn't like that age based stuff.
Oh shit! Yeah, that time we went to play, I took a double stack of this age based shit, and.
A lot more body intense.
Right, yeah, and it hit me really fast. We were playing pool, and it hit me. I feel it like hit me really fast because I parachuted it. So it just like went right.
What do you mean?
wait, a parachute. You take a piece of toilet paper, and you tear it apart.
You take a 2-ply and you turn it into a 1-ply.
Right, you make it into 1-ply, and then you crush it up, put it in there, and twist it up like one of those snap pops. You know.
Oh,
essentially, when it's already broken up, so when it hits your stomach, right. It just the paper,
right?
So it just
like helps all stomach acid, right. And then you just see it. It's not so much I'm fucking mad about it, as much I'm fucking confused, because here I am, you know, and I think I'm a pretty fucking good boyfriend. You know, I put the fucking effort out there, and I'm not so fucking mad as I am fucking just confused, because I'm putting forth the effort, I'm listening to what she's saying, and I feel like I'm doing my fucking part. I moved here. I didn't need this place. I didn't need the fucking bigger place or the bigger rent that I'm paying on my fucking own now.
Look,
as soon as
Ben.
We goddamn fucking move in.
Ben! Listen to me. I'm your friend. I love you, and Alicia, she's a great girl, okay? But fuck her! She left. She didn't say anything. She doesn't deserve a second thought, man, you know? You're lucky she left. And you're stuck with an apartment and not mortgage and kids and shit. Point being, I know what you're going through, okay, right? You've been in a relationship for what, like 3 years now? It's hard. You miss it. But that's fucking conditioning, man, okay? Especially these days. You can go to a bar and you can find a dozen women who are just as sexy as Lisa. Go out. Go out! Fuck them! Fuck them all! They're just sitting there waiting to be fucked, okay? I think we should get fucked up and go find some strange. Marinate on that for a minute.
Well, fuck it, I'll go. I'll go to the fucking bar. You wanna go to the bar?
No Screaming Eagle shit, huh?
Dennis?
I can't, man. I gotta go home and be with a wife.
That's cool, man. Uh-huh. You wanna call Lindsay?
Yeah,
great.
Sis.
Alright. Later, man.
You guys don't do anything stupid.
Let's fucking, let's do it.
I love you. I still love you.
That was not that great of a friend.
Oh!
No!
God. Who's up next? I'll go.
So I'm pretty sure that chick Tiffany's not gonna talk to me anymore.
Yeah.
Well, so I met this chick at the bar, like, Saturday night. And I was supposed to see her the next morning. We were supposed to have brunch and shit. And so the chick ended up staying the night. And of course we messed around before she left that morning. And I forgot that I was supposed to see her. And I don't know if this has happened to you before, but this has literally never happened to me in my entire life.
Couldn't get it up.
The
smelliest, it's never happened to me before.
Oh. The smelliest pussy I've ever seen in my entire life. They have smelt
in my entire life.
Yeah, but it looks like it smells. But I forgot about it, though. I forgot about it quickly, because, you know, after, like, an hour or so smelling something, you forget about the smell.
Sure.
So I didn't realize that it had permeated my entire house. So she
your
didn't even get close
like
to my face. She basically walked in my living room and just told me that my house smelled like pussy.
Did your neighbors complain?
No. It didn't make it outside of the house. But...
is it still open?
It's still open.
Oh, okay.
Lindsay's here.
I'm really upset, though, because she had one of those, like, cartoon pussies. You know what I'm talking about?
You know, as much as I love stories about pussy right now, I'm not really in the mood to talk about pussy.
You remember Caroline, right?
Yes, I remember Caroline.
Oh, when we met, she asked to bum a cigarette from me. And then 2 weeks after that, she pretended that she was a smoker just because she was too embarrassed to admit that she only bummed a cigarette from me, so she got a chance to talk. Well, I at the time, I thought she was the one. But, you know, we broke up, and she just vanished. I mean, she was gone. After that, I remember laying in my bed, staring at the ceiling, remembering that night that we fucked for the first time. It was a Thursday, and I had to leave to go get condoms, as usual. Sorry. But, I remember after months and months of being fucked up, I realized that day that I was the asshole. And Caroline was smart, and she was sexy. She was funny. She wasn't the one. But all we did was swap cum and playlist, and there's no connection, there's no love behind that. I mean, you can find that anywhere in the world. But, I mean, it's all the arc there was in our relationship anyway.
Punchline doesn't make any sense. It's like completely obscure. Yeah. It'll be like, so like, why did the toilet paper cross the road? And it'll be like, tax reduction.
Okay. It was made by a 6-year-old.
Right. Yeah, no, I know. It's from like some 6-year-old in Illinois. Like,
there was
girls
a girl version
in the kitchen.
But there was a girl version of the exact same thing where you could like make butterflies and unicorns.
That is so goddamn sad. I know.
No, that's not fair. I mean, you have easy bake ovens, then you have creepy crawlers.
Easy
and
bake
that's it.
was the guy thing that was like made so women knew their place edible. At an early age. It was just like, yeah. You belong in the kitchen.
But at the same time.
Because some women and feminism in modern day society is not about women forcing themselves to wear pants. It's about having the freedom for everyone to choose. So men should be able to have easy bake ovens if they want to as well.
Would preach you it. Have one?
Men? So do you want another beer?
Would you do an easy bake?
Do you want another beer?
Over a creepy crawly machine?
No, yeah, dude, easy bake?
I'm good.
Totally
I'm good. I'm gonna head home.
Crawler, because I want cookies.
One more
I want fucking...
No.
Come on.
The easy bake frosting, like, I would buy that shit just by itself. That's I'm just saying. It's
what the fuck? It's midnight.
Yeah, you guys are leaving?
Go. Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah, it was so nice to meet you guys.
Yeah,
but
nice.
We'll see you around.
See you around.
Definitely.
Later, man.
Bye. Cheers, guys.
Have fun being boring as hell.
Bye. I can't believe you're all this, like,
I'd go on summer suns, orange glow.
let the starlings fly over this flight.
Hey.
Did you have fun tonight?
Yeah. Whoa, whoa, babe. What are you doing?
Do I have to spell it out for you?
Babe. I'm tired.
Never sent to buy you tightly in the shrinking memories, a name on the tips of the tongues with nothing remind.
Naomi Mackwick. Hi.
Hi. How are you?
Good, good. Just give us 1 minute, if you don't mind. Okay. Sorry about that. How are you doing, Naomi?
I'm good. How are you?
Still good. Did you have any questions before you're going?
No, I don't think so.
All right, well, let's go ahead and geek on the mark there. Excellent, excellent. So, I'm gonna go ahead and read with you. Let's grab a slate first, and we're just gonna need your name. And...
Hello, I'm Naomi McCuick.
Saints.
We don't want any. Get out.
Gave it the office. Typical.
What's up, man?
Hey, lady.
Ben, some sandwiches?
Now.
Are
see your house is less dirty. That's nice.
Some money.
I was hoping I could do some money today.
Loosen it
up. Actually.
Ooh, there she blows.
I hope silver.
You don't even know who you're dealing with.
Michael, put it on here.
I'm dealing with you, Ben.
No, that's your hand.
And
you don't know. Ben's
don't
know.
The dealer. He's just said, we don't know who we're dealing with.
Oh.
That's your hand. Those two cards in front of you, that's your hand,
that's,
in case you didn't
see
know.
This?
You?
Not here or here as much.
Just.
But,
oh my god. But, fucking bet.
That's there you go. Call.
Check.
Pot's good. Let's see him. Burn 1 foot three.
Pot's real good.
Oh man, that's what everybody wanted to see right there.
Ooh, he's got the five and the seven.
That is on me, and I'm gonna I'm gonna try and buy it again, so let's just go 50.
Okay.
Oh my god, but this. Okay.
Okay, well, it's good. Burn one. Burn one, flip it.
Oh, no.
Let's go with Dollar.
I'm done.
Wow.
I fold.
Wow.
I'm done.
Wow. Alright, pot's good. Burn one, flip the last one.
Why are you still.
Because it's fucking, he's just trying to buy the fucking pot.
Pot's good?
Yeah, okay.
Let's see the next card. Right. You just call?
I'm gonna call. Yeah, okay. You go.
Ready for flush.
Take it down.
What are the odds?
All right, that deck goes over there.
Hey. I'm sorry.
lost?
Lines went up.
It's 3 a.m. I'm at home with my fucking wife. Say that again. Great. Great. You're drunk, right?
This used to be one of my favorite places to come. Little kids. Dennis and I would come out here and drink and smoke. Can't remember the last time I was here.
Why are we here?
I wanted to apologize for last night.
It's fine.
No,
it's
I'm not apologizing for what I did. I'm apologizing for how I did it.
Not much of an apology.
Did you tell Dennis?
No.
Why not?
Why did it happen, Ben?
I think back to when you first started coming around, and I think back about how you and Dennis could have just as easily been you and me. And I know sometimes when I look at you that you're feeling what I'm feeling.
Stop. Look. Ben. Yeah, the thought has crossed my mind before, but that's exactly what it was. It was a thought. A thought. You and me, we can speak in hypotheticals all we want, but the fact is what could have happened last night didn't. I'm married to Dennis. That's the way it is. And yeah, things are not really that great right now, but it doesn't matter. Look, you and I shouldn't even be having this conversation.
Souls can feel but cannot say. In these rooftops get a sunset so magnificent now every day. The ring of hope not forgotten. Behold her dear eyes as the sun drowns in her eyes.
Hey. Are you okay? What's up?
I have to ask you something.
Okay.
And I don't want you to get mad when I ask. But I need to. And I need you to be honest with me.
Yeah. Sure.
Are you sleeping with someone else?
What?
Because if you are, it's okay. I mean, it's not okay, but I'd rather you be honest with me.
Naomi.
Because if you're honest with me, then I'll know. And I won't feel like I'm fucking crazy anymore.
I don't know why you would ask me something like this. I don't. After everything.
I'm scared. You've always made me feel important. You've always made me feel safe. But I'm feeling really scared now. Because things don't seem to be the way they used to. And maybe I shouldn't be feeling like this. Maybe I really am crazy, but it's gotten to the point where I feel I need to ask you. Will you please just be honest with me?
I don't know what I've done to you to get you here. I've been nothing but good to you. I've worked my ass off, taking care of you this entire time so that you can pursue this hobby of yours carefree. I've done nothing wrong. The fact that you would even fucking ask me that question disgusts me. With absolutely zero provocation.
Just answer the fucking question, Dennis.
I have to leave.
Yeah, of course you do.
Thank you.
Lisa. Are you okay? Just talk to me. Talk to me, just say something to me. Fucking say something to me. Talk to me. I can't do this. Fucking talk to me. Just fucking talk.
I'm sorry.
Just fucking talk to me.
Hey. I hope it's okay I'm here. I wanted to surprise you.
Yeah. No, it's fine.
I brought junk food. And more junk food.
Game changer, ladies.
But I'll raise you another $2.
talk about.
Oh, you're such... I'm going to do it anyway.
You should do it, because he's full of shit.
All right, lads.
All right. Excellent.
Where's you been?
Yeah, I'm looking at my fucking guard.
It's dented. My trumpet's dented.
I'm sorry tonight.
I have the best trumpet.
Really?
Do you just want to call?
I do.
Okay. So put it. Just put in another white. That's good.
It's all part of my master plan.
It is. I mean, he's breaking us down and building us up.
Mel Gibson and Maverick. He's
thing,
just
exactly.
I guarantee
y'all did that thing already, so these are good to go.
Are we raising the blinds?
Do you want to raise the blinds now that I'm on the big blind?
Well, no, you put in 20, is what I'm saying.
Oh, okay. That's fine, too.
Saving you, Mike.
Gentlemen.
Oh, it is.
That's my shuffle.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Phil, what's on you?
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. It's on me. Let's go, 50.
Call. Actually, I'm gonna take off. I think I'm gonna go see that Madeline chick. Really?
What, Nicole Shrimp from the bar?
Yeah. Yeah, we've been hanging out. A lot. She's, that good, huh? Yeah. Yeah, I guess I kinda like her. Anyway, I'm gonna go. I'll see you guys later. Do you wanna go grab a beer?
Okay.
Nice toss, man.
What's going on with you and Naomi?
What do you mean?
Come on, I've seen you. And luckily, Dennis hasn't.
I don't know what you think you've seen, but you're wrong, Mike.
You gotta be kidding me. Do you just want me to? Do you want me to say it? Do you want me to go ahead and say it to you?
Okay, yeah, spell it out for me. What the fuck are you talking about?
Are you fucking Naomi?
Jesus Christ, Mike.
You're really gonna do this?
You're being serious.
Come on, man, just cut the shit. And be straightforward with me. Just answer the question.
No, I'm not going to answer the question, because it's a fucking ridiculous question. I don't know what you think you saw when you walked in on us, but there's nothing going on between me and Naomi. And honestly, I'm a little fucking pissed off that you even asked me something like that. What the fuck is that, Mike?
The guy I've known since you were 10 years old, man. And I know... It's fine. If this is how you want to play it, that's fine, man.
I want to play it.
I thought we...
Okay, you want me to be honest?
I thought we were better
I'll be honest business. Right now. This is none of your fucking business. So why don't you just drop it? Just drop it, Mike. It's none of your fucking business. All right. You know, hey, thanks for the beer. Oh, and go fuck yourself.
What am I supposed to do?
Just mind your own fucking business.
One friend fucking another friend's wife is my goddamn business. Don't you...
Are you okay?
Where's Dennis?
He's asleep. He had too much to drink.